Hello, everybody. I have the remote control for the slides, so I have to do it manually, right? So first of all, I'm going to present myself. I'm Spanish. That's why the hola thing's there. My name is Angel Diaz, and I'm part of a consultancy group, a group of independent consultants that is called Agilar. Right, so what's this presentation about? This presentation is about using design thinking to hack the culture in organizations. Wow, what a complicated stuff. So how many of you are currently involved or were involved in a cultural change or a change into Agile? Cool. Was it easy or difficult? Super difficult. So this talk is about that. It's about a clue that I can give you. Because I work in a huge transition in a bank, and I survived. Right? Yeah. I had my hair was long like this, but I survived the transition. And I had a lot of learnings out of that transition, out of that world, out of that very difficult endeavors. So I'd like to underline one of those to give you a clue that may be helpful for you in the future, right? So I will start with a piece of the story that is behind this transition. So this is Agile in Bankland by Angel Diaz, myself. So one day, this is me, right? So one day I had to climb the Mount Bank Olympus, right? I faced this big organization with a lot of monsters, sorry, a lot of managers, a lot of hierarchies, things that were grabbed from other bigger companies, other bigger banks, the Taylorism, this old way of management, all that stuff. And I was so determined to change that, right? Whenever someone tells me that something is impossible, I go there. That's for me, right? I can change that. So I really had a very, very interesting goal, so I decided to change my life, actually change my life, I changed country. I was living in Canada at the time, and I decided to go back to Spain to accept this endeavor, right? So when you do such a big investment, such a big bet in your, life, you're going to get that, right? Nothing would stop me. I had to change the bank. I have to tell everybody that it's actually possible to change a big organization into an agile organization, right? So the first thing that I wanted to do is to convince everybody that it was right and they were wrong, and agile was the way to go, right? So I decided to fight everyone in my way to change the organization. So I started convincing the people, right? Just like this, yeah? So I draw those lines in my face, got into steroids, right? And then I started pulling everybody's head in order to change the organization, right? By choice. This is me now, right? The organization was too big. But this is another story. You will maybe know the end of the story in a different talk, because at the end of the time, the bald guy succeeded, right? Changes the bank. This took me 3 years, losing the head, right? Losing the hair. I was bald before, right? But obviously, it was a very, very difficult endeavor. But I had so many learnings from this experience, right? And out of that experience, anybody started me asking me, how can we convince others to change? I make agile to happen in my organization. How can I do the thing that you did? And my answer to that is that don't do it. Don't do it. It's impossible. You can't change people. Hopefully, you can change yourself a little bit. Not much. Sometimes it's very difficult just to get into a diet, change habit, quit smoking. So imagine how difficult it is to make all the people to change. It's completely stupid, but we are so proud of ourselves and so naive that we think that we can change all the people, that we have to change all the people. So what I learned is that it's not the way to go. You have to change yourself. So what can he change in order to make all the people to change a little bit? And the most interesting thing about this is that you don't know what direction are they going to change. But at least you know that something is going to change, right? So as long as you can do something in yourself that can help others changing, you don't know where, but changing, that is good, right? It's not being static. Is develop your empathy. This is what you want to change. This is what you can change. Develop your empathy. Understand more about others, right? So you can change something in yourself that can help them changing their behaviors, right? So to me, this was a very good finding, right? So I wasn't being empathic at all. I was just worried about my endeavor, my mission. I wanted to change the organization, but they didn't want to change, right? I completely forgot about them, about my customer, about my peers, about my allies, right? I forgot about that. So I came to know a bunch of techniques that are used for product development, product design, and for service design. There are the design thinking techniques that are based on empathy, right? Should you understand more about your customer, you understand more about the people, should you develop a better, you design a better service for them, you design a better product for them, you design a better experience for them. So I wanted to design a better experience for the people regarding Agile, right? So I decided to try it out. The design thinking processes that are appointed or that are specifically applied in design and in service design and product design into agile transition, changing cultures, right? So how does a design thinking process work? Usually do some observation, right? So you get more context, you understand more about your customer, about the people that is working in your organization, in this case. Then you come up with some ideas, some stuff that can help you creating some leverage on that observation that you made before. And then you prototype that. You prototype the solutions, the ideas, the actual levers that you are going to move in order to have something changing, right? This is how design thinking processes work. So getting a little bit more into the details, because this is usually a workshop, a hands-on workshop that lasts 2 hours, and I just have like 10 minutes more or something like that, right? So I will give you a little bit of a flavor about how is this about, right? So the most important thing is don't do it yourself alone. You have to do it with more people, right? Because you have to understand the organization. So maybe it would be interesting just to gather people from marketing, people from QA, people from IT, DevOps, developers, Scrum Master, right? And with that people, you start observing your environment. How can you do that? A very easy technique that you can do to do that, you might know, is personas. How many of you know the technique personas? Okay. How many of you tried personas with the people within your organization to understand your people that you are trying to involve in your agile change? Cool. So this is the point. One easy thing that we can do is some personas. Understand the people that we have within our organization to get a little bit more of a context and make it more public, right? Another technique that you can use for that is the empathy map. How many of you are familiarized with the empathy map? Okay. It's a very easy technique, right? It's a very easy technique for brainstorming, where you just draw this person here, and you put this thing here, feel, and say, and you put sticky notes, right, for a certain persona that you identified before. Say, for example, we have this top management. that we want to involve in the agile change. So here's our manager. What do you think he thinks about agile? He hears about agile, he feels about agile, and he says about agile. So doing this yourself is not as valuable as doing it with more people from within your organization, right? So you get more context, right? Another thing that you can do is just observing or doing some peering or shadowing to get more context, right? Okay, next phase. Then you go into ideation. This is where you want to identify things that you are that you can actually use in order to lever those behaviors, right? You got some context. You see some things that they think or they say or they heard about Agile, and you want this to change somehow. So you want to generate some ideas that can become levers for that things, that factors that you identified before. A way for doing that technique that I really like is thinking in reverse. How many of you know this technique, thinking in reverse? It's awesome. I really like it. I really like it also for retrospective. Yeah, when you have a team that doesn't know how to overcome being static in retrospective, being repetitive, it's a very good technique to use. So it's just, what do you want to do? What do you have to do in order to make that guy hates Agile, right? So you brainstorm and come up with things that you can do in order to make him hate Agile. That helps you thinking more, diverging, right? Creating new knowledge, right? This is also useful for retrospective. What can we do in order to make the next sprint the worst sprint ever? It's very useful. Trust me. Another technique that you can use for that, for the ideation, is identify patterns, behavioral patterns, and understand or create ideas about how to break those patterns, right? Repetitive behaviors in meetings, repetitive behaviors trying to command and control. What is this happening? So how can I create a lever to break that pattern, that thing that is repeating, right? So it's a good thing to try it out. Before we get into the prototyping, I'd like to draw something for you that I think is very interesting. So every brainstorming technique works this way. Okay. You start with no knowledge. So hello, hi, we are starting to brainstorm. And then you start diverging. So creating knowledge that you won't create if you think just by yourself. So this is the linear thinking. This is the lateral thinking, right? Has any of you heard about lateral thinking? Okay, great. So it's like you are so static, right? Okay, maybe it's because I'm Spanish, so I move a lot. You know, I'm very talkative. Okay. So we want to encourage this kind of thinking, right? This lateral thinking. So for that, we want to diverge, create knowledge that we weren't creating just by ourselves, right? We're going to do a small exercise regarding that just now. And then you want to choose some stuff that is interesting from this and converge. Yeah? And hopefully you pick stuff that is here and here to work on. So this is what you want to get out of any of these brainstorming techniques that you want to apply. Right? So I think we have time, we can do a little bit of an exercise. So you have a post-it note, right, in your booklet, right? So just write a small fact about you, and a small something about you, not physical, just a fact about you that describes you, the thing that better describes you. This one fact about you. Okay, you got it? Okay, now choose a partner, and you have 30 seconds to talk to the other guy, to the other person. Why did you choose to write that? Okay? 30 seconds, go. Okay, done, okay, done. I know it was quick, okay. You know this? Do you know this? In the Agile community, we usually do this. So when someone raises his hands to ask for attention, anyone who sees this guy raises his hand and shuts up. So it's like a peer pressure, right? for asking silence. Awesome, great. So now we have this piece of paper, and we're going to do this, right? So we are going to give and change the paper with another person, randomly. Just change the paper. Change the paper. And if you see that you have the same paper again, change it again. Change. Fast. Okay, fast. Okay, great. Are we all done? No, not done? You have the same one?
No.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so we all have a different fact in our hands? More or less? Most of us? Okay, so now we're going to do exactly the same. We are going to explain our partner why we decided to write that fact about us. Because you decided, right? Okay, 30 seconds. Explain. Okay. Wow, it worked awesome. Awesome. Thank you very much for that one, Dan. Okay. I'm getting to that. I was about to do that, actually. So what was the difference between the first one and the second one? What's the difference between the first part of the exercise and the second part of the exercise?
The second one, you interpret the idea of another person.
Exactly.
In the first one, you know exactly what you meant. In the second, you guess.
Exactly. So the first one was very comfortable, right? So you create a small universe of knowledge, and you share that knowledge. And this is awesome because I create that. I believe in this, right? It's what I did in the very beginning of my agile transition. I believe in this. I create this knowledge with all the colleagues of mine that we believe in agile. This is for you, right? In the second part of the exercise, two different things could happen. First, that I feel identified with the stuff that I got. So someone else created a different universe of knowledge, and I try to investigate myself or explore myself in that universe, right? And another thing can happen. No, I'm not there at all. That's not me, right? But the thing is that in the second part of the exercise, we force ourselves to explore, right? Okay, Lisa Atkins, thank you for this exercise. I learned this exercise from Lisa Atkins. So what we want to do in this dynamics, in this design thinking, is to explore, to understand more about a different knowledge, a different universal knowledge, a different point of view, right? That is the point of view of the people that you need to work with you in that transition. Because this transition is not your transition. It's their transition, right? So you have to understand more about their context, about their universe of knowledge. Ala. Okay. So once we got this new universe, these new ideas, right, we can get into prototyping. What does it mean, prototyping? So for products or services, it's much easier to understand how prototyping is, right? It's paper prototyping or whatever. So for this kind of prototyping, I like the storyboard, for example. So we draw a story that happened with that person, right? You run into some manager, you organize an open space, you organize a pro-action cafe, you organize a retrospective, you organize, prepare a PowerPoint presentation for a top management committee, something like that, right? This is the moment of truth that you are going to face with that people, right? With that people here. Those moments of truth. And as you do in services, you focus on these moments of truth. So the first contact with the customer, the second contact with the customer. If you do the same stuff for Agile, so you prepare for the first contact that person will have with Agile. Because if you don't prepare, you will pay that back, right? That bad feeling about Agile. Oh, Agile is about no planning at all. Scary. It's about no documentation. If that is happening, it's because you weren't prepared for that moment of truth, right? So this prototyping stuff is getting prepared for that moment of truth and have the right message for them to involve them in the Agile movement from the empathy. Now that you have enough context, now that you have enough information, right? Plans are useless, but planning is everything. And this is about planning, it's about the strategy. It's about to create a strategy for that point of truth, point of contact, moment of truth that you will have with that people in your organization, right? So that moment has to be perfect. It's like the first date, right? It has to be perfect. So this is the prototyping I meant, right? Get ready to that moment of truth. Draw that moment of truth. Understand what is going to happen in that moment of truth, right? So wrapping up, what you learn among all the things in this big transition to Agile is that you don't have to treat people as professionals, because before we are people. We have fears, we have families, we have hobbies, we have more interesting things to do than just go to work. So this is the this is the understanding that you have to have before try to create those moments of truth with that people. You have to understand that they are people, right? So this is my piece of, let's say, advice of tips that worked for me in this big transition. So I encourage you to try this out, and that's all. Hope to enjoy it.